Hello friends, myself Dr. Devesh Mishra and I am a pathology faculty, and today I am going to discuss the next episode of the special stains in pathology, which is part 2. As I have told you that previous section that I am going to discuss in multiple sessions because it's a little bit longer lecture. So in part 2 we are going to discuss about the connective tissue, a special staining used for the connective tissue, and in this I am going to tell you about one more thing. Here I want to tell you that about my app. There is a DPMA pathology app, and if you subscribe this app you can have a great advantage in your exam also. So this will be available at this website, and I have consistently seen that from my lecture from past 12 years that more than 40 questions are coming in the NEET PG exam and more than 25 questions are coming in the AIIMS, PGI and all these central institutes, right? So it will be very useful for those students, and many students have been benefited by this app. So if you want to subscribe, you can use this website www.idpma.co.in. And there is another good thing which I want to inform you, that there is my book called Concepts in Pathology and Pathology Notes, right? And in this INICET exam, which has happened in November 2020, 25 questions were from my app, and there were more than 29 questions which came from my book and notes, right? And my book and notes you can subscribe from the devanshpublications.com, right? So don't miss this opportunity, utilize it maximum, and you will definitely get great advantage in your exam, because this will correlate to the clinical scenarios also, and it will be helping you to solve questions which is coming in your clinical subject also, right? So let's start about this special staining. Here I'm going to discuss about this connective tissue special stain: Masson trichome, Gomori trichome, Gordon and Sweet reticulin stain, Picrocereus red stain, Mowat's pentachrome or seen, Wiggert resorption, fusion, Verhoef Wann-Jaissen stain, and phosphotungstic acid hematoxylin, right? So these are the names of the, special stains which we are going to use for connective tissue. Now I am going to tell you detail about these things. So first one, if you look at the Masson's trichome stain, right, the name itself is a very, very important, and in Robbins also there was a image given here. What is this actually? This stain is used to distinguish collagen from the smooth muscle in a histopathological sections, right? So please remember, it is for identification of the collagen will be identified by Masson's trichome stain. What is the basic confusion? Is the muscle. So collagen versus muscles we can identify by Masson's trichome stain. And in trichome stain is also used to differentiate between collagen and smooth muscles, and to find out more collagen within the tissue. And how will be the interpretation? Now you can see that muscles, whatever muscle will be there, they will be coming in the red color, right? And collagen will be blue in appearance. So now you can see the blue color, which is, in the background, these are all collagen. So blue color, these are all blue color things, which are collagen, right? Red color is either RBC, this is the red color, this is the RBC, and this red color is the collagen also, right? So muscles are red in appearance. So these are the smooth muscles which are red in appearance, and these are the collagen which are blue. So basically Masson trichome is used for distinguishing collagen from the smooth muscle. Collagen will be blue, muscle will be red in appearance, right? So this is number one stain. Second is Gomori's trichome stain. So this is also very important and very widely used stain for the collagen. But here in Gomori's trichome stain, collagen will be green in color. So here it will not be blue. Here it is green. So all these green color is the collagen. And this is the Gomori's trichome stain. There is another important stain, Gordon and Sweet's stain, which came in AIIMS 2017. Gordon and Sweet's reticulin stain. Remember, it is for reticulin fibers. Right, so reticular fibers are detected by Gordon and Sweet stain, right? Basically it is used to identify liver pathology. So now you can see that there is a black colors, which is reticulin fiber, which are corresponding. So reticulin fibers are black in appearance, right? And nuclei will be red in appearance, right? So nuclei is not very much red in this biopsy or in this specimen, but you can see in the background little bit reddish or pinkish appearance is there. But most important to notice is the reticulin fiber is all dark or black in appearance, which are surrounding the hepatocyte cells, right? So this is the Gordon and Sweet cell for the reticular fiber in the liver histopathology. There is another beautiful stain called Picrocereus red stain, PSR, right? So Picrocereus red stain is again used for the collagen, and collagen will be red in color. So now you can see around the blood vessel collagen is there, and all red color is the collagen in the Picrocereus red stain. So remember, Picrocereus red stain color of the collagen will be red. It is for collagen, and collagen will be red in appearance, right? Next one is another important stain given in Robbins also. An examiner can ask you this question in an upcoming exam. Mowat's pentachrome stain. So there are five color, that's name itself is telling. Mowat's pentachrome stain. Where we are using, basically it is used in the pulmonary and cardiovascular pathology for identification of the vascular remodeling, right? And it is an excellent, you know, stain to, you know, identify the long-term collagenous fibrosis. So basically it is to distinguish between the very late or advanced fibrosis from the recent fibrosis. So late and recent fibrosis can be distinguished by Mowat's pentachrome stain, right? So what will be the, you know, what will be the appearance? Elastic fiber will be black. So now you can see these are black color, these are elastic fibers, right? Mucin will be blue. So you can see mucin, this is our all mucin. Mucin will be blue in appearance. Muscle will be red. So you can see muscles are looking red in appearance. Muscles will be looking red. Collagen is going to be appearing like a blue, yellow in appearance. So collagen is yellow. Fibrin is not visible very clearly, but you can see here fibrin, there is a very small area. This is the fibrin. Right, dark red color or bright red color. So bright red color is the fibrin, right? So this is the pentachrome. You can see five things are there: elastic fiber, mucin, muscles, collagen, and fibrin. Elastic fiber is black in appearance, muscles are red in, mucin is blue, mucin is blue, muscles are red, and fibrin is bright red. You can see bright red color is here, and collagen is yellow in appearance, right? So this is the Mowat's pentachrome stain for the collagen detection, and this can differentiate from the recent fibrosis from the older fibrosis or advanced fibrosis. Orsine is another good stain, special stain, which is used for elastic fibers or elastic fiber as well as for HBS antigen, right? So hepatitis B surface antigen, which is showing you ground glass appearance when you are seeing the liver biopsy, right? So for elastic fiber and HBS antigen, right? It is, as I have told you, for the liver biopsy. And what will be the color? Dark brown color. You can see all these dark brown color which we are seeing. Dark brown or brownish red appearance which we are seeing is the elastic fiber. And collagen will be pale brown. So collagen will be pale brown like this. These are the collagen, right? Pale brown is the collagen. And dark brown or brownish red appearance will be the feature of the elastic fiber, right? So orsine is for elastic fiber and for hepatitis B surface antigen. Wiegert resorcin fusion stain. Remember, this is very, very important. Wiegert resorcin fusion stain. Again, it is used in cardiovascular pathology to identify the elastic fibers in the paraffin sections, right? And how will be the elastic fiber? They will be dark gray to black. You can see these are the elastic fiber. So this is the Wiegert resorcin fusion stain. Remember, Wiegert's resorcin fusion stain, where elastic fibers are looking dark gray to black in appearance, right? And a beautiful special stain is Verhoef-von-Jeysen stain. Verhoef-von-Jeysen stain will be having, you know, it is used for, again, for collagen and other connective tissue. So it will discriminate between collagen versus other connective tissue. How will be collagen? Collagen will be red in appearance. Remember, collagen will be red. So you can see all the red color is the collagen. All the red color is the collagen. Elastin fibers and elastic lamina will be black. So you can see this black line is elastin fiber and elastic lamina. You can see one outer line and there is a this one elastic fiber, right? And nuclei will be blue black and other tissue will be yellow in color, as you can see in the background. So what is important here to understand is the collagen. Collagen will be red color, elastin will be black color, right? Collagen will be red color, elastin will be black color. So that is how you are going to identify Verhoef-von-Jeysen stain. It is for collagen versus elastin, right? Now, this is another important stain, phosphotungstic acid hematoxylin, which is also called PTH, right? So PTH is also used for the, for collagen and fibrin. So basically it is for fibrin. So it is phosphotungstic acid hematoxylin stain, where we are having mixture of phosphotungstic acid and hematoxylin, right? Phosphotungstic acid and hematoxylin, and it is used to stain collagen and muscle fibers. And this is also good for the striated muscle fibers, mitochondria, contraction band necrosis. All these things can be seen. So fibrin, striated muscle, glial fiber, all this will be looking blue in appearance. Right? So now you can see the dark blue appearance. These are all fibrin, striated muscle or glial fiber. And collagen will be brown red color, which is very, not visible here. round red color. Nuclei will be blue. As you can see, nuclei are looking blue in color. Very feeble, you know, collagen you can see here, which is little faint color, right? Brown red, right? Here you can see, right? And this is the another biopsy where we can see contraction band necrosis in the heart. This is the kidney biopsy and this is the heart biopsy, right? So always remember, PTH is for muscle fiber, collagen, fibrin, all these things can be stained, right? So that's all about in the second part, connective tissue staining. Next part, we are again going to discuss some of the important special stain. So here again, those who want to subscribe my app, DPMA e-learning app, you can go to my website, that is the idpma.co.in. And those who want to subscribe pathology book or notes, you can go for a subscription at that devanshpublication.com. This is another website. And stay tuned with my YouTube link where I'm going to update the third part of the special staining. So till then, bye-bye and see you and best wishes.